Hello guys, today I'm gonna telling you about the 555 timer and its mode, istable mode, bistable mode and monostable mode. So this is the basic circuit diagram of 555 timer. It consists 20 transistor, 15 resistor and 2 diodes are involved in a one single 8 pin chip, and nowadays depending on the company that manufactures it. So this is the 8 pin 555 timer and this is a systematic diagram. You can see it. So now talk about first mode, istable mode. So this is the circuit diagram of istable mode, which is work as free running mode. In this mode, the output comes in a square wave generator. Like the best example of this istable mode is light of ambulance, means indicating light of ambulance. So it is the best example for a perfect square wave. They are used as an inverter and also used in many of the internal part of the radio, selecting as a thermistor, as a timing resistor. In this circuit diagram you can see this, there is a R1 and R2 resistor connected, which is used for duty cycle and frequency. You can change its frequency and duty cycle. In next circuit I will show you how to use it. So 0 volt and VCC. VCC is a plus 5 and 0 volt is a minus 5. So you can connect battery here and you can make your circuit as per your demand or as per your idea. Output is a pin 3, or there is a one capacitor 0.1 nanofarad. It may be neglect or it may be used 0.01 microfarad. It is only used for to reduce the oscillation and harmonics. So this is the formula for frequency and duty cycle. You can change this frequency and duty cycle. Duty cycle, that means a pulse comes in low and high two types. So you can change the bandwidth between positive and negative. Like that you can use this circuit in washing machine, which work in for some time clockwise, for some time anti-clockwise. So you can change the duty cycle and make any project regarding to this circuit. There is some theory written that this type of circuit could be used to give a mechanism intermittent motion by switching a motor on and off at a regular interval, that you can see in washing machine. At interval it works in clockwise and anti-clockwise. It can also be used to flash lamp and LEDs for indicating the light for some signal, and is useful as a clock pulse for other digital ICs and circuit. Capacitor 0.1 nanofarad is just to filter the noise, and its value can be suitable chosen to be 0.01 microfarad, or it can also be neglected. So this is the basic circuit diagram and formula for istable mode. Then comes to the next, bistable mode. So this is the basic circuit and its output waveform of a bistable mode. A bistable mode is also called a systematic trigger. It has two stable states. This is a very good logic. You can see it. If you press trigger button, that if you connected a LED to a output pin number 3. If you press trigger button, your LED will glow for infinite time if you didn't press reset button. If you press reset button after 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 2 minutes or 10 seconds as per your demand, then it will off. That means if you connected LED to the output, if you press trigger button, LED will glow. If you press reset button, it will off. So you can make any circuit regarding to this, like you can control any relay, you can control any lamp, you can control anything circuit which you make. If you connected a relay to the output voltage, if you press trigger button, it will on after some time or few time or as per your demand, what time you decided. If you will press reset button, it will off. So this is very good bistable mode. You can use this circuit and make any project, and you can see in waveform how it works. If you press trigger button, it will on. If you press reset button, the waveform will be down or high and low. So this is all about bistable mode. Now comes to the next, monostable mode. A monostable circuit produces one pulse to a set length. Set length, that means whatever you set this output time. The best example of this circuit diagram, that means if you are making a lamp, means you press a button for 10 minutes. You can decide its time like that. If you are, if you have any concept, if you have any idea to make any project for limited time, that means you wanna glow LED for 10 minutes. You can set time regarding this circuit or using the circuit. Now read some theory. A monostable circuit produces one pulse of a set length in response to trigger input, such as a push button. The output of the circuit stays in the low state until there is a trigger input. Hence the name monostable, meaning one stable state. This type of circuit is ideal for use in a push or operate system for a model displayed as exhibition. A visitor can push a button to start a model's mechanism moving, and the mechanism will automatically switch off after a set time. In this circuit diagram, you can see there is one R in ohm, one capacitor, one noise oscillation capacitor, and output 0 volt and VCC. See its waveform. If you give input, it means a trigger. If you give input and after some time it will automatically down, it will automatically off. You can see in output pin number 3 waveform diagram. I'm giving one good example. The output pulse ends when the voltage on the capacitor equals 2 by 3 of the supply voltage. The output pulse width can be lengthened or shortened to the need of the specific application by adjusting the value of R and C. There is one formula given: output time equals to 1.1 into R into C. That means 1.1 is fixed, R will be in ohm, C will be in farad. Example, if you are making any project, if you connect any LED to pin number 3, then how to set its time? Take example, we take a resistor of 100 kilo ohm and we take a capacitor of 100 microfarad. The first thing is convert kilo ohm into ohm, microfarad into farad. So T equals to, in red text you can see that T equals to 1.1 into 100 kilo. Kilo, that means 10 to the power 3. 100 into 10 to the power 3 or 1000 into microfarad, converted into farad. It means you have to multiply by 10 to the power minus 6 into 100 into 10 to the power minus 6. You can see time. T equals to 1.1 into 10 equals to 11 seconds. Means if you use this value of resistor and capacitor, your output time will be 11 seconds. And it's a fixed 11 seconds. Use this R and C value and connect your circuit as per their circuit diagram and give a trigger. Give a trigger or any push button you can use. Give a trigger. The output will come only for 11 seconds. You can reduce and increase this time value to change their R and C value. Output time will be for 11 seconds. It means if you give trigger on input, then your output connected LED will glow for 11 seconds and then it will automatically turn off. And if you press 1 second trigger, it will 1 second work for 11 seconds and then turn off. So this is all about the very simplest and easiest way of 555 timer. You can make any circuit diagram, any project regarding this circuit, and it is testable circuit, you can use it. So thank you guys. If you like it, please subscribe and comment and share it. Thank you.